Hello everyone, this is work in progress with my colleagues of the Mexican team, Isalia Nava, René Lascano, and Elvira Cedillo. The goal of this work is to identify generational differences in labor income and consumption in Mexico during the transition from a period characterized by a closed economy with high economic growth and price stability to one with high volatility and frequent economic crisis, but that ended with moderate growth, price stability, and open markets. Mexican economies have subdivided the entire period into shorter phases based on economic policies and indicators of the epoch. We use this categorization to guide the interpretation of results and the selection of cohorts for this paper. We hypothesize that generations born during the period of economic stagnation and globalization would likely have lower labor income and consumption levels than previous generations. Here I show the compensation of employees relative to GDP after 1970 to illustrate this point. We see that it declined abruptly after the first economic downturn of 1982, and then continue declining and closely related to the economic cycle. Data for labor income and consumption NTA profiles between 1992 and 2014, all expressed in constant Mexican pesos. I show in this figure the rate of growth of labor income and consumption, which grew at the same pace and followed the economic cycle very closely as well. Here I show the labor income age profiles for all years in our sample, relative to 1992, represented by the orange solid line. Labor income increased in 1994, but then declined sharply in 1996, during the aftermath of the 95 crisis, and started recovering until 1998. Similar patterns were observed in the aftermath of the 2009 crisis. Here we have the profiles for selected birth cohorts by age, keeping the 1992 and 2014 age profiles. The 1965 birth cohort in green increased with age, but it was affected by the 1995 and the 2009 crisis, reducing the growth by age and shifting the peak at an older age. We can also appreciate that labor income will have increased for this cohort at a larger pace across age in the absence of economic downturns and delaying the age where it peaked. The 1955 cohort seems particularly affected by these economic shocks as well, perhaps explaining this large gap with the 1965 generation. We performed the same analysis with the total consumption, and the results across periods are like those for labor income in terms of real declines or stagnation at all ages, during the aftermath of the respective economic crisis. In this case, a distinctive characteristic of the consumption is the flattened down of the profiles at all ages. Similarly, we observe a clear pattern of increasing consumption by age for all cohorts, with the effects of economic shocks shifting the trajectories to the right and delaying the age when consumption peaks for all of them. For instance, look at the 1965 birth cohort in green again. Had no economic shocks had occurred, the trajectory across age will have reached a higher peak, perhaps 15 years earlier, at age 35 rather than 50 in this example. Although the previous descriptive analyses are very illustrative, we rely on APC methods trying to identify cohort trajectories not determined by age or period trends. However, the APC analysis has the disadvantage that APC effects cannot be determined independently because of the linear identification problem. For that reason, we are using several approaches with different underlying assumptions for sensitivity. For now, we show only results for two of them. The median Polish approach removes the additive effects of age and period in the first step, and then the resulting residuals are then regressed on indicator variables for cohort membership using linear regression. On the other hand, hierarchical APC models are two-level cross-classified random intercept models with age nested within period and cohort at a higher level. This method avoids linear dependency by specifying age in the fixed part of the model and period and cohort effects in the random part. Labor income and consumption APC scores are then calculated using MCMC methods. The results for these two methods are consistent. That's a good sign, but we interpret them with caution and based on supporting data and economic events. All graphs represent fixed or random effects estimates of period and cohort trajectories. The period profiles are consistent with the economic cycle shown before. On the other hand, we have that for baby boomers and Generation X, we observe positive increases in labor income that peaks for the birth cohort around 1965, then it declines. The decline continued and became negative for the millennials cohort that were born during the period of volatility and economic stagnation. In the case of consumption, the period effects are very similar and closely related with the economic cycle again. In the cohort profile, consumption increased consistently for baby boomers and peaked for Generation X, to start declining for the millennial generation and turning negative by nearly 2000. As I said earlier, this is work in progress and we are still working on the Deaton and Paxson model for sensitivity. We are also planning to include NTA data from 2012 to improve our estimates. Finally, we are considering the potential mediation effects of education and work status, most likely in a follow-up paper. Thank you very much.